Lazarus was very sick.
Lazaro avabye ngopfu.
The sisters to Lazarus.
Bo sesiya Lazaro.
Sent a message to Jesus.
Ba rumela mulaetsa go ya go Jesu.
Advising that Lazarus was very sick.
O mutsibisha gore Lazaro o ya lwala ga go lugolo.
But Jesus delayed to go there.
Mara Jesu a ditetega go ya kwa gona kwa.
Because he wanted the worst to happen.
Ka gore o ba nyaka gore tse dikgolo di direge.
So that people can see the glory of God.
So gore bana ba ta bona matimba ya Xikwembu.
When he went to the tomb of Lazarus.
Ge a ya kwa lapeng la Lazaro.
He instructed the sister Martha.
O laetse sesiya Lazaro Martha.
He said, Martha, remove the stone.
Wile ar Marita.
Martha said, there will be bad odor coming.
Marita are kutanungango fui kale munuloi afi.
Out of the grave.
Ujamolibike.
Since Lazarus had been there for 4 days.
Bialokare Lazaro avale molibiteng majajia man.
Jesus insisted that the stone be removed.
Jeso wila pirelela urlisiga. Letoche.
When the stone was finally removed,
he said,
Lazarus,
Jesus or Lazarus,
in a loud voice, come out. The dead man came out. Lazarus was resurrected despite the fact that the sister wrote him off.
Hey. Lazaro wila tsuswa le ga ile gore sesia gagwe o ba dikadika a bolela gore o tlongkha.
Children of God,
bana ba mudi,
I'm standing here.
Ke eme mo
in my office.
Oh, mushumo ngwaka
as the servant of God.
Bjalo ka mohlanga wa mudi,
decree and declaring.
Ke bolela ke tshi
that those who sought
gore botle bana ba bana ga nang,
they buried anything concerning your life.
Ba bolukile tshohle ka ga bophelo bja
gago. Today, right now,
le khono na motla hinkarelo,
they have another thing coming.
Hey, lo tshe dingwe di atswa.
Those who thought that your finances were buried, the future of your children were
buried,
they have another thing coming.
Hey, praise the Lord.
My mothers and sisters, those that rejected you, those who left you with kids, those who left you for another woman, those who called you names because of your past will be put to shame today. As God is doing a brand new thing in you, as you have entered Canaan, the land of milk and honey, God is restoring your glow. Your dignity is being resurrected and restored. Your reputation, resurrection and restoration. Your husband, resurrection and restoration. Right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let me tell you, if you are not married, now because you have entered Canaan, the land of honey and milk, when you live here, you are going to meet a man of your dream. Those who are married, the husband cheating,
whose
husbands are non-believers, I decree and declare in the presence of the Holy Spirit that when you live here, that when you
gore ga o tloga mo.
Your husband is going to follow you everywhere you go.
Hey, monna wa gago o ya o shala
mo. Let me tell you. Let me tell you.
Ere go
botse. Those who are jealous.
Hey, ba o bona le mona.
Those who know the behavior of your man previously.
Hey, ba o ba tseba megwa ya gago ba ya monna wa gago ya
pele. I'm saying you gave him love potion.
Amen.
Not knowing that restoration took place.
Hey, basa tsebe gore dilo di buyela mayebo.
Not knowing that resurrection took place.
Hey, ba bolela basa tsebe gore go buyela ga dilo go tlherisela ka swilo swi teke swiendleki.
My sister, let me tell you this.
Bana ba sharing ke le botsese.
Those who rejected you.
Bao bao ganne.
They will come and rejoice with you.
Batotla bathaba lwe.
From rejection to rejoicing with you.
Hey, batotloa mo ganwe wa bae bathaba lwe.
They will come and rejoice with you.
Batotla bathaba lwe.
When you get married to the man of your dream.
Ge o nyalana le monna wa ditoro nuna wa miloro ya wena.
They left you.
Ba o tlogetse ba go tshekile.
But it led to upliftment.
Hey, go tlogela mo.
In your mind, you are saying that they left you because they don't love you anymore. They're not longer interested in you. Let me tell you, they left you because they lack the qualities.
The qualities
and principles.
Batoka botsebi le melao
of carrying out the duties of a prince.
Gore ba tswele pele ka ba tsebe meshumo ya
mang. Because you are a princess.
Hey, ka hore wena o khoshigadi.
As your father in heaven is a king.
Bjalo ka ge tata wa gago a le godimong e le khoshi.
Now I want to speak to my brothers and fathers.
Bjalo ke bolala ke nyaka o bolala le botiti le bopapa.
My brothers and fathers.
Hey, bo sa se le bo bo.
Those who disrespected you.
Bo ba o nyaditse.
Because of your background.
Ka ba ka la maemo a gago a kwa mora.
Because of your filthy color appearance. Because of your financial circumstances. As I'm standing here in my office as the servant of God, I decree and declare that now since you have entered land of milk and honey, they will start respecting you. Those who look down on you, they will look up on you.
They will respect you.
Background resurrected and restored. Financial circumstances, resurrection and restoration right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You know what? Sometimes we work very hard, but we don't have something to show. As the result of our hard work. As a result of our commitment and dedication. But since you have entered Canaan, the land of honey and milk, I decree and declare that those blessings that were invisible, they are becoming visible in the mighty name of Jesus. Those blessings that were intangible. They are tangible as I speak right now.
Oh,
They are not becoming visible and tangible for you to brag about. But they are coming visible and tangible so that people around you will have reverence for the God that you are serving. Let me tell you, my brothers and fathers, where you come from, you'll be used as a point of reference. To show that indeed God is able. Do we have pastors here? Do we have evangelists?
Yes.
Special greetings to you, my mothers and fathers. Let me tell you,
Pharaoh
held in captive that which belonged to you for a very long time. Pharaoh held captive that which belongs to you for a very long time. But today, Pharaoh has lost grip. He has lost grip of your calling. He has lost grip of your visions, your dreams, and your wisdom. As I speak right now, I'm not saying tomorrow, but right now, your calling is being resurrected and restored in the mighty name of Jesus. Your wisdom, resurrection, and resurrected and restored. Your visions, resurrected and restored. God is giving you a church with its own kind. As a pastor, you have no stress. And you'll have more joy. Because you have entered Canaan, the land of honey and milk. Let me tell you, you will never run out of wisdom. I decree and declare in my office as a servant of God, in the presence of the Holy Spirit, that you shall never run out of visions as a pastor. Because it's resurrection time, it's restoration time. Amen.
Amen.
My dear pastors,
Baruti baka
baba, because you have entered Canaan,
ka gore wena o tsene kana,
the land of honey and milk, when you preach,
hey,
the demons that used one direction to come to your place will run using seven directions.
Seven times.
When you preach, sickness will bow.
Hey, Satan will
because your calling is now resurrected and restored in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My pastors, God sent me to you. Now that you have entered Canaan, don't sugarcoat the gospel. Pardon? Don't sugarcoat the gospel.
Hey!
For the sake of getting likes and shares on social media.
gore wena o tlo kwetse matumo le matla a maka go batho ba di radio le bo mamang ba di newspaper.
It is better for you to not to be a celebrity of social media.
Go kaone wena o ska ba mamoratwa wa ba di pampiri le ba di radio.
But have your name registered in the book of life.
Mara o dira gore lengwalo la we leina la gago lengwale bukeng ya bophelo.
My pastors, today God is saying, as servants, you know the mandate that the devil is carrying. The devil is carrying the mandate of stealing, killing, and destroying. Now that you have entered Canaan, the land of honey and milk, be a different pastor.
Hey, banam fundisi longa fani kina bangwanyana man.
Oppose each and every mandate that the devil is carrying.
Hey, ana raga muraro kamuka wo Satan already.
Because your calling is now resurrected and restored.
Kaur pichwe gago itsugile itsushitwe ibushalitse mayemong awe tshwanetse go ba mogwona. Amen. Amen.
Instead of stealing, give back to the poor.
Ifa by the sheep.
Instead of killing,
save
soul.
Hey, pollution.
And that will make you a different pastor altogether, carrying the mandate of heaven.
Pastor kumbe mfundisi lwanga faniki na bangwanyana.
You know, when I came in the morning,
let's iba Hussein,
as I was preparing the word of God, after preparing, I became very sick. And prepared the word of God as if nothing was happening. Those who saw me while I was sitting there,
when people were standing up, I always sat up.
Because the devil is trying to destroy my health. I aggressively told the devil, whether I'm sick, I'm not sick, I'm going to preach your gospel today. I'm going to preach God's gospel today. Here I am now, standing here, very strong, preaching the gospel of God. Those who came here with sickness, those who came here with doctor's report, I decree and declare that as I'm speaking right now as a servant of God, your immune system is being resurrected right now. Your health is being restored. You might be experiencing failure in your life, in your business, in your school, in your career. I decree and declare that any failure in your life is terminated with immediate effect because you have entered Canaan. The land of honey and milk. Every evil deposited in your life, is uprooted in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you very much for your time.
This sermon was brought to you by Pastor Sibite Baloyi. For more updates, follow us on Facebook and subscribe on YouTube, Divine Grace and Gift of God Church. And for more information, contact us on 083-559-2151.